Hey guys, and welcome to the wonderful multiverse of Premiere Basics, where I teach you all the variants of Adobe Premiere Pro. And if you're not getting any of the things I just said, then you probably haven't seen Loki yet. So spoiler alert, because today we're recreating the intro animation from the brand new Disney Plus series, Loki. Let's get started. It's actually not that hard to make, but it's a bit of work. First off, let's make a new text layer, which you can do by hitting the text icon here in the toolbar or with the key combination Ctrl T. We're going to type Loki in all caps. Now open up the Essential Graphics panel from the window menu. Now choose a desired look for your title. So set the font size, the font tracking, and so on until you're pleased with the result. Now make sure that your text is aligned in the middle of the screen and that there is enough space between all of the letters. This will be important later on. Next, we're going to go to the Effect Controls panel and open up the Loki text. Set a keyframe for the source text. And now we can basically animate everything from this property, but we're going to change the font because that's what Loki series also does. Now select the first letter, and this is super important. So in this case, it's the L. Then go 10 frames further in time and change the font. Then go forward another 10 frames and change it again. Do this for however long you want it to be. Now you will notice that these keyframes are hold keyframes. And this means that the value within doesn't gradually change over time. The font will change from one to another without morphing, which is exactly what we need, so this is perfect. Now quick tip here, if you have a huge font library, try and find maybe 10 fonts that you want to use. Either write them down somewhere or open them up in an Illustrator or Photoshop file, just so that you can have a quick look at their names. If you don't know where to find fonts, you can always go to Adobe Typekit. Once you're done with the L, it will look a bit like this. And next, we're going to select the O and go over all of these keyframes again and change the font. Now make sure that it isn't the same as the font of the L at that moment. Now you can quickly go forward and backward between the keyframes with the arrows right here. And if you don't want a specific font but just randomly select one, you can make it yourself super easy and just scroll with your mouse above the font list like this. It's like a roulette. Now once done with the O, proceed to do the same with the remaining letters. Very important, don't forget to always highlight a specific letter first. Glorious purpose. Oh, wait. But while we're at it, I know what you're thinking. This could have been made easier in After Effects, probably way easier, right? Well, yeah. But heck, most of you probably don't even know how After Effects works. So what are you gonna do about it? Well, very simple. I'll show you how to master it. Take no offense, my friends, but Premiere is worthless in the face of a master editor's sorcery within After Effects. Head right to the first link down below, which will bring you straight to After Effects Beginner's Class, where you can learn how to start with After Effects, create masks like I do from time to time, blend layers to composite ultimate illusions, create effects that are superior to anything you will see in real life, learn how to make amazing animations by using keyframes, green keying, so you can put yourself anywhere at any time. Mask tracking, motion tracking, 3D camera tracking, I mean even the TVA contract like that. Start learning how to make motion graphics, shapes, advanced animations with expressions that look like spells, and of course, learn how to export all of that so you can show your amazing video to everyone in the multiverse. And all of that by just clicking that first link in the description down below. Oh, and the first 2 weeks are completely for free, so definitely check it out. Thanks, alternative chill. Proceeding with our intro now. Go to the effects panel and look for the Gaussian blur effect. Place it onto your text layer and set the blurriness to a really high number, like maybe 450. And scroll to the bottom and set the blend mode to screen. Next, duplicate the layer by holding Alt while dragging. Set the blurriness to around 15 and set the blend mode back to normal. Then go to the effects panel and look for the roughen edges effect. Drag it onto your duplicate layer. Now I kinda like the default look of this, but you can always adjust it according to your likings. Now go to the project panel, right click and make a new adjustment layer. Drag it above the existing text layers. And go to the effects panel and look for the noise effect. place it on the adjustment layer and set the noise amount to 30 or higher. Once again, this depends on the look that you want, of course. If you really want to replicate the original title intro, we really need to have a look at the details. In the background, there are multiple textured backgrounds, so if you want, you can always download a couple of those and place them underneath all of your layers in the timeline. Now the colors are also slightly blue in the shadows and yellow in the highlights. So with an extra adjustment layer, we can go over to the window menu and open the Lumetri color panel, and from there you can add some colors. Now this is already looking really great, but there is one thing missing, and that's the grungy scratch effect. Now you can make it yourself easy and download a scratch video from the internet, place it on top and change the blend mode, or you can create one yourself. Place another adjustment layer on top of everything else and set the VR fractal noise effect on it. Then change the fractal type to strings. Set the contrast to 400, the brightness to minus 100, and animate the evolution and see it over time. Then set the opacity to around 50 and change the blend mode to screen. And bam, the intro animation is done. That's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial as much as I enjoyed watching the Loki series. Now, if you haven't seen it yet, I highly recommend it. If you want to see more effects, then let me know in the comments down below which ones you really want to see. But don't forget to give this video a like, subscribe, and turn on the post notifications to stay updated whenever we upload a new video. I'll see you guys next week for a new tutorial. And as always, stay creative.